Is there any animosity between you and the opposition?
Yeah, yeah, there is.
Laura Neal, the wannabe league tag player, thinks she's good. She's hopeless. I tell you, she can't kick a ball to save a life. What about you, mate?
Yeah, look, mine's got to be Hayley Ward.
Well said.
It's the outrageous seating plans that she puts us in, and just not for it. So she'll see it in the Harmon Cup.
Good call. What else? Pete Henson?
Who is he, really?
Don't even get me started on him!
3, 2, 1, go.
So, gentlemen, how are we feeling about the Harmon Cup?
Confident. Personally confident.
Yeah.
How do you feel?
Just another W. We're going all the name. Yeah. At home. Just another day.
It's an interesting looking trophy, isn't it? There's 12 wins, 0 losses.
Well, I suppose we should talk about how the trophy looks because the students haven't really seen much of it.
You might see it when we hold up later on. But yeah, what was your original question?
Who would you say is the biggest threat on the students' team?
Threat. Threat.
Can you define threat? Gun?
Oh, I really can't think of anyone. I just thought you guys were lucky to kick a ball.
They've got a B grade keeper, which I think is going to be.
Oh, jeez, what? Full compliments today, mate. B grade.
But yeah, he's a nice enough kid. Ollie Jones, good runner of the ball. Mitch Price, quite athletic.
So Chad Mayer, once with the students, now with the teachers. Thoughts on that?
It's just natural. I want to be the only winner. We won the game, no other students have won. NPL players, come and gone, still can't win. All age D grade, we win.
Your staff room partner, Simon Williamson, what's he bringing to the team?
Heart, dedication. Watch your ankles, he'll take you out. So, the ball will go past him, but you won't.
So aggression, that's what you're saying.
No, you won't be aggressive. Just passive.
Don't see you taking out Dylan Moore as a sort of disrespect to your badge.
No, gotta do what's gotta be done.
Sian, you're one of the few soccer players on this team. You see that as a leadership role for yourself?
Yep.
You're leading the team. You're leading the team?
Yep.
That's the way to do it. Amy,
do
you have any
soccer experience?
I do not.
McGowan,
that's like 2 McGowan.
McGowan,
he's getting.
I think fitness is on our side this year. Volleyball session has really topped us off really nicely. So I think fitness will be us this year.
Yeah, I think I've got 80 minutes in me. There's a couple of teachers that probably won't have 80 minutes. We'll sub them out pretty quick. You've got the likes of Matt Erich. He probably won't push out more than 6-7 minutes. Miss Ward last year was only capable of 10. Who else do we have?
We got Heidi. Yeah, he's not as fit as what he used to be. So
Williamson? He looks fit.
Yeah, he looks like a marathon runner, but yeah, he won't push out anywhere near those.
He's not a canyon marathon runner. That's just his shape.
Hi, I'm Brace Ridley. Brace Ridley, 5'2", 18 years old. Junior Football Club, Cardiff Cougars. Position, goalkeeper. Strength, huge head. Weaknesses, female. Motto, if you're not first, you're last.
Oh yeah, baby!
Hi, I'm Chris Lefe.
Christy, Chris Lefe. Height, 3'4". Size, foot, 13 men's. Strength, aggression. Loading stop, visual.
Dylan
Chaz Morgan. Nicknames, the Chef. 5'9", size 6, women's foot. Weakness, legs. Strength, lives at Merriweather. Motto, I like it.
Tweaking out that 2CB, huh? This is why you pick with me, huh? Smash, she gon' end up on TV, huh? Last thing that you ever wanna see, huh? I can feel the spirits all around me. I think Prince and Mike is tryna warn me. They know I got demons all on me. Devil been tryna make an army.
So, how did the Harmon Cup come about?
So Harmon Cup came about when Mr. Harmon was diagnosed with cancer and it wasn't looking really good early on. So we decided as a staff what we could do was to raise money, and we came up with an idea of a soccer game. So we started that in the first 2 years. The first time we kicked off, we had Harmo there. Second year, he was very frail. And then since then, unfortunately, we haven't had him. But it's just kept going with a fundraiser for the school. It helps with the scholarship. It also helps in the local community as well.
What are you looking forward to most in the Harmon Cup?
I love the Harmon Cup. Played every year since it has been about. It's a good day to remember Mr. Harmon, who was one of our role models at the school. And that's one thing most teachers here aspire to become. It's my year group, so this year's a little bit extra special for me. Looking forward to running around on the paddock with them, playing around with some staff and taking out some of the kids that have got under my skin over the years.
What's your favourite part about the day?
My favourite part is, I suppose it's the memories that I've created with students, and just see how each year group adapts to it, and then being able to, at the end of the game, shake someone's hand and someone come up to you and say, thank you for letting me be a part of that. I'll always cherish that. That's something that, you know, that for me, it typifies Harmon. You know, it's not about the winning. It's about everyone having a go and being the best you can be. So they're the sorts of things that I take from it. It's just those little memories, those little bits through every game, and just watching what the school, how the school adapts to it with the bright colours. As soon as you walk in the school on that day and you see all those bright colours, it's really touching how they're still representing a teacher who passed away 10 years ago.
No one at this school now has met Mr. Harmon.
Yep.
Or had the opportunity to. What's some advice that you could give students now that he'd pass on to students?
So his whole thing near the end when he came into school, say hello to everyone, he had an opportunity to talk to about four or five kids after that, and he signed their shirts, and it was Chase Your Dreams. And then I thought, since then, I've used that for my year groups, which was his year group. We've used it to sign off some speeches. I've got it tattooed. And I think that typifies what he was about. It wasn't just about winning. It wasn't about things. It was just about that every student at this school has a chance to do whatever they want to do. It might take some hard work, but you can do whatever you set your mind to.
Perfect.